Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of ChassisSim Technologies. And welcome to this latest ChassisSim video tutorial. And today, ladies and gentlemen, what I want to cover with you is a little known feature of ChassisSim that's very, very powerful. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, the ChassisSim Suspension Geometry Viewer. So let's get started. Now, as I have covered on some earlier tutorials, to manipulate the geometry points in ChassisSim, if we go click here to adjust points, this brings up your XYZ coordinates and you fill that in, bearing in mind, ladies and gentlemen, that the ChassisSim datum is the front axle center line on the ground. So all of your suspension geometry points are measured with respect to that datum. Z is up, Y is across, X is backwards, so the X is longitudinally. Also too, particularly with asymmetric setups, just to refresh everyone's memory, with asymmetric setups, you always put in Y as positive because ChassisSim will do the handling for that internally. Now, one of the things that I've discussed on a number of occasions is that when you've entered these points, you can click on Analyze Configuration and this returns your four spaced roll centers, your four spaced anti-dive and your four spaced anti-squat. So you might be thinking, that's all well and good. The other thing too, ladies and gentlemen, is that you can click on Export Settings to export that geometry out, and you can also click on Import Settings to import that geometry in. However, ladies and gentlemen, let me show you a really handy little tool. And if we click on the tab called Suspension Analysis, and we click on, say, the left-hand roll center application point and the left camber, what this is, ladies and gentlemen, is a really handy little tool for you to go through and take a first passed cut of what your suspension geometry design did. Now, a few caveats here. Firstly, this doesn't replace the four spaced roll center or camber channels you get back from ChassisSim when you do a data log. Now, one of the great things about ChassisSim being fully transient is that you can get to see how the camber and how the roll centers are going to change with all the bumps. So clearly that's the final word. But rather than going through and doing a number of simulations, the great thing about this is that, for example, if you make a change in here, so let's just say for the sake of the argument, I'm going to, say, take point 2 here and move that up by 10 millimeters. I'll go Analyze Configuration. I'll go Apply the Calculation, and I'll go OK. And what I can then do is go into Suspension Analysis, and I can then see what that's actually done to my... I can then see what that's done to my suspension geometry. So you can go through and play with all this. But the great... First things first, one thing I do want to say is that while this is a powerful tool, please note that this is not a replacement for things like WinGeo or SusProg. I think both WinGeo and SusProg do what they do very, very well, and this is not meant to sort of tread into that territory. What it is, what you can do with this, though, is you can do this for very, very quick changes. The other thing, too, is that you'll see here you can load geometry. Now, you'll note here in load geometry, you can add a left-hand side and a right-hand side. What that means, if you are analyzing an asymmetric suspension, this will return what the effects of the asymmetric suspension is doing. So if we had loaded some asymmetric suspension here, we could click on the right camber and you could see what it's doing. The other thing too, ladies and gentlemen, is that you can see what it's going to do. So currently we've got the roll mode. So this is the car purely in roll. But if we were to go into pitch and heave mode, this will return what the car is going to do if the chassis is moving up and down. And the other thing that we can do, ladies and gentlemen, we can take a look at what the left tire deflection is going to do and what the right tire deflection is going to do. So, and also too, ladies and gentlemen, the other option that you've got is that you can print the other option that you can do, ladies and gentlemen, is that you can also print this analysis out on a piece of paper to see what it's doing. So again, ladies and gentlemen, let me stress that this is not a SusProg or a WinGeo replacement, but the beauty about this is, particularly for the members of the ChassisSim community who have used this, they find this a really, really valuable, very, very quick tool that if they're going to go through and play with their suspension geometry, they can then use this to have a very, very quick look at what it's going to do. The other thing that you can do, depending on your car, is that you can put in your setup input parameters. So, for example, if I was doing something like an open wheeler, I'd probably set that at 20. If I was a touring car, I'd set that at 60. It's totally up to you. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let me leave you with that. But don't take my word for it. If you're an existing member of the ChassisSim community, have a play with this. If you're not an existing member of the ChassisSim community, download our online sim, register, buy a few simulations, and give this a test drive for yourself. And we'll catch you in the next ChassisSim video tutorial.